So let's start with the case creator and show the capabilities of this. What can this actually do here? So when I'm starting to develop those cases here, definitely for a unit test, and maybe for a workflow test, again, it will depend on the complexity here. This is the thing that I want to start with. After I've created my suite, I would come in here and I would tell it, I want to do, so we'll start with the unit test. And then I want to go ahead and select incident. And then I want to check off all the boxes here. Some of these are disabled now. I've removed the templates for these, and I don't know if they're going to stay for notifications and navigation. They did not seem to have a lot of value, at least how they existed before. So I may deprecate these. I'm kind of leaving them in there just to see how people feel about them. But the other ones here, business rules, client scripts, policies, actions, and form layouts, those are definites. We must absolutely automate those ones. So I'd want to check all those off and then click save. Once I do that, now it's going to go out and it's going to pull all of those records, all of those configurations, and it's going to create the record or the case for me, but it's also going to try to generate the content for that case as well. So let's look at a few of these and see what the capabilities are. I'll start with the form layouts here. This is what we get generated. It usually has two parts, the run before. So this is the setup. We're going to get big into these setups here. And then the script, which are going to be the different validations or actions that it can pull out here. So what this is saying here is like this, I can already see this one here needs to be fixed. The template for this will basically be to look at each of the fields on the form that's part of this view and go through and validate the label, whether or not it's mandatory, if it's read only, if it's hidden, and then the default value. This generally works. Okay, this would need to have quotes around it, by the way. But this generally works here, no problem. And you could take most of these sections and run these immediately and get a good result. There are definitely times in here where like a client script or UI policy might take over and change one of these values. That is definitely expected. It can't, like, we don't go through and evaluate all of the rules when we generate this script. We just take the default value, but it's easy enough to just flip that or change that in here. So those are kind of expected. I bet some of these might change once the UI policies are applied. The other thing it will look at too here is, okay, here's an example here. So the default value, if it's a hard-coded value, wonderful, it will take it in and use that no problem. If it's something like this where it was JavaScript or something on the server side that renders it, it takes that and puts that in here. I thought about removing this here, but I actually think it's a little bit more helpful to see this because this is very obvious that this was supposed to be scripts there. And that this is telling you, like, this will definitely fail, and that's something we want to highlight and fix there too. So this would be an assertion that we would want to change. But that's the more important than the individual code here. It's the workflow that I think is important. I want to take this script, and I want to, as I go through these and validate them, I want to validate this script runs, and then I want to move the state to active or something here. So how would I get to that point? Now I want to introduce the other tool here, Mini, and I'm going to take this because I want to save this script. I want to use Mini to go through and validate these different pieces. So I would actually take and put into Mini the different, the different pieces of the script here. I have a feeling that a lot of these lines are going to fail here. And I would execute these, this script in its entirety here. So I want to execute this piece and then watch it actually run. So I'm going to put this, I'm going to reshuffle these windows around here. And I'll show you the actual flow that I would take through this here. So once that test was generated, let me give this a second to log back in. I want to use this Mini tool now to go through and validate it. So rather than run the whole thing, I'm just going to run this small section so I can see what it would do. So I run through, and I don't want to see this. I want to see that, everything is passing green, right? I would probably, because this one is so long, I might do this in sections here. So and go along and do those validations. If, as I was more comfortable with it, I might run the whole thing at once here. This might take a minute to go through, so I'm not going to run this whole thing, but that's what I'm trying to get out of this flow. Validate this, you know, validate this. If there's any changes that I've made, I want to bring those in, and then I want to flip the state to active once I feel like this is in a good, kind of in a good spot.